Hello and good morning, Daily Bread friends and family. I want to say thank you and welcome to our weekly prayer. To everybody who is out there listening, we invite you to join us on Sundays at 11 a.m. online or in person. As I said, we are back live in person, so you can come out. Please don't forsake the assembly of his people. With that, if you will, bow your heads as we get ready to go in prayer. Most heavenly and gracious Father, we want to say thank you. Thank you for another opportunity to uplift and honor your name. Thank you for the blessings that you bestowed upon us and the blessings that you continue to do in our lives. Lord God, you know the hearts and desires of your people. You know our wants and our needs. And we ask your people just to trust and believe in you. For you tell us not to be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. We just ask your people just to trust, hold fast, and steady with those beliefs. Knowing and looking to you for all our guidance and our understanding, we know that you can do all things but fail. Lord God, some of your people are going through some things today. We just ask them to continue to trust you, to continue to believe you, continue to follow you, continue to just give everything unto you, and just to continue to prayer and steadfast seek you. For Lord God, we know that you are our way and our light. With prayer, Lord God, we know the destitute does not despise our prayers, so that we know we can ask of anything of you. We know that you can do anything, and we know there's nothing that is too big for your grace and your mercy. Lord God, we tell your people to confess their sins to one another and pray for one another, that they may be healed. For the prayer of the righteous person has great power as it continues to work. Lord God, we know that prayer works. We know that we continue to confess our sins as we all fall short of your glory, for none of us are perfect, but we all seek to be Christ-like in all our endeavors. Just continue to keep our eyes focused on you, Lord God, and everything that you would have us to do. Lord God, as we continue to watch and pray that we may not be tempted, for Lord God, we know that the spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. So while we may be weak in our flesh, as long as we continue to seek you and all our spiritual understanding, we know that you can pull us through. That we all know that we may be tempted, but we all know that you can bring us forward. Lord God, we say thank you in advance. Thank you for all the blessings that you continue to do in our lives. Lord God, we ask you for increase. We ask you for favor. We ask you for blessing. We ask you for knowledge. We ask you for wisdom. Give us that power of discernment to allow us to know those things that you would have for us. Lord God, we ask you to open the doors that are made for us and to close those ones shut that should be put behind us, Lord God. Lord God, we say we just trust you today. We trust those people you've instilled in front of us, those leaders you've appointed over us. We ask that you just guide their paths, guide their hands, guide their tongue, Lord God. We know that those things that are being spoken to our lives, that you will put people who will be those mentors to us, who will be those guides for us, those ones who may know more than we know about ourselves, Lord God. We just ask that they just continue to pour into us, speak from a place of love, from a place of care, from a place of wisdom, and a place of knowledge, Lord God, that they will do those positive things for us and nothing to ever harm us, Lord God. Lord God, we ask your people just to continue to open up to you, continue to go forth in this world, continue to preach and minister your word, Lord God. Lord God, we ask that we may be a beacon of light that draws people in troubling times to you, Lord God. We ask that they just continue to be that path and that guidance towards you, Lord God, so that we may take a world that is caught in the flesh and have them look towards the spiritual understanding. So as I get ready to end this prayer, Lord God, I say thank you again. Thank you for being who you are, for being the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Thank you for everything you've done in our lives and everything you continue to do. So for all these things and more, we pray and we ask in your darling son Jesus' name. Amen. Again, join us on Sunday. I want you to have a wonderful and blessed week. Thank you for joining us. And until next time, be blessed.